The Spring Experiment is a unique opportunity that brings researchers, forecasters, and academics to one location where we can discuss and try new technologies that will become part of the weather field in the future.
Both forecasters and researchers get to, in effect, walk in each other's shoes. Forecasters get to do what researchers do in testing ideas, and researchers participate in the forecasting exercises, which is typically something that they don't do every day, and they get to see firsthand how their techniques and approaches work in real life.
It gives everybody a chance to see what's out there, see what's coming down the pipeline, see what works, see what doesn't work. Gives you a chance to interact with a forecaster who you might have the greatest idea in the world, but if he doesn't understand it, then there's really not a whole lot of point of working on it that way.
It's really valuable not only to get the different perspectives from the different groups of people who are here who, you know, have a different background, but also as a motivational tool for doing research. And you come here and see the newest models, the newest forecasting tools that are available, and then at the end of the week you go back thinking, well, I wonder if there's something else we can learn from this.
The experiment occurs in the spring, typically from late April into the middle of June, because that's the prime time of year that severe thunderstorms and tornadoes occur.
You know, we're watching it happen. This is not a case study that's happened last year. You know, it gives them a real-time environment to play with it.
Nobody knows what the answer is going to be. It adds more to the excitement of the entire experimental forecasting process, and it makes it easier for visitors to understand what some of the real-world operational challenges are.
Case studies have their place, but really in the big scheme of things, you've got to be able to use it in real time. Case study, you've got days to assimilate the data. Real time, you've got minutes.
One of the best things that happens in the feedback from forecasters to researchers is the researchers understand what is needed in operations to make better forecasts.
It gives you a really good insight to how to make it better, how to switch something over, I really hate that red color. There's too many false alarms, wow, the resolution really stinks, or hey, can you do it this way instead? It gives you an idea of where to go.
It's really two-way feedback from the researcher to the forecaster and the forecaster to the researcher that improves forecasting down the road.
There's really no other avenue for scientists and meteorologists from every range of university and research and operational forecasting to come together and to try this technology out and to work together to benefit the science.
It's another step on the way to improved forecasts for severe weather, better warnings ultimately, better preparedness hopefully for the public of where and when severe weather is going to take place.